Today I'm going to be showing you how to make homemade thermal grease or thermal paste using household items. Now, this is primarily used for testing. If you absolutely positively do not have thermal grease or a heat sink and you need to test the machine, test the board. I only recommend this as a temporary solution. You really should go out and get an actual heat sink and thermal paste or thermal grease. Now, this idea came from Tom's Hardware from many, many years ago, so it's something I wanted to test to see how it works. It's primarily used in third world countries like Ghana and in Sakawa to get old boards or broken boards up and running again so they can use them online. So with that said, let's begin. For this tutorial, you will need something to mix it in, some vegetable oil or olive oil, some white toothpaste. I do not recommend the gel paste or anything that's colored. A tin can, preferably a soup can or a smaller can, and something to mix with and apply it to the heat, to the CPU, like Q-tips. Now, based on what I've read, it's supposed to be kind of a 50-50 mixture, and we don't need a lot, but I'm gonna make a good glob here, that way everybody can see it. Basically, the toothpaste is used to thicken it up. The oil is used to keep it wet. And make sure you mix it really, really well. Otherwise, it's going to get runny and it's just going to go onto the motherboard. Now, if you look at the ingredients of the toothpaste, there is some water in there. So you do need to be careful. The oil is anti-static, it's non-conductive, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, so onto the motherboard. Right now I switched the system fan and put it onto the CPU fan, that way we don't see fan errors. You may have to turn detection of system fan off, and what we're going to do is just take a little bit on the tip of the Q-tip. I mean, you do want enough to make contact with the tin can. So, since there's a small divot in the tin can, we may have to make a big glob here, just so they make contact with one another. Now, if you have a flat bottom can, obviously you don't need that much, but as I said, this one has a little divot, so we need it to connect. So to improvise, I did put the can on its side to make better contact. Obviously, you just kind of work with what you got. And this actually I think is going to work better because then I can put the fan blowing into the can and get some more cooling. And if you really want to go the extra mile, you can drill some holes in the can and in the back so there's actually air escaping. This is just to show you kind of what it looks like right now. And that it is making contact with the CPU. And let's turn it on and do some testing. Okay, so now we're ready to do some testing. We have the homemade thermal grease, thermal compound on the CPU with the can. Now, unfortunately, we couldn't just have the can on top like we had planned, but you just kind of work with what you got and continue on. So let's see what we get. Gonna jump the pin here to get it to turn on. Well, so far it looks like it's loading. And it has turned off. So why did it turn off? This may be a failed project. Okay, so the soup can did not work. So we're going to try a couple different things here. First of all, the can is magnetic. Now, when the can is magnetic, you know it's not aluminum. So we're going to switch to just a standard can, cut it down, and see if we can put that on there and see if it'll work as a heat sink. Also, I think I'm going to try toothpaste directly, because when our mixture heated up, it started to just get really, really watery. So either it needs more toothpaste, or I'm just going to go toothpaste directly. Okay, so our first test started to boot up and then just beeped out because it got too hot. So right now we're using a little bit of an aluminum can and toothpaste directly. Let's see how this works. Okay, power to the board, jump in the board. Hoping for a better result. Start normally. Well, we're getting farther than we did before. Nope, there it goes. Okay, so using a tin can, I can safely say this is a busted method. This does not, if it worked in the past, it doesn't work anymore. So we're going to skip this idea. And what we're actually going to do is get an actual heat sink and use our concoction to see if that will actually still work. Let's put our original mixture back on the CPU that we saw before, so I don't have to show it again. Put a good glob on there. Okay, so it looks like we may be in good shape here. The screen says CPU was previously shut down due to thermal event, overheating. Press enter to continue. Start normally. Now keep in mind, this is a standard 775 heat sink and fan with the mixture of toothpaste and olive oil. And it looks like it's actually starting up this time and being our friend. Okay, so what we learned was that the tin can, I guess urban legend, is debunked. That just shows you don't believe everything you read online. However, we were able to use toothpaste and olive oil to create thermal grease because it is working, it is on. We're not getting overheating issues. And the computer is actually functioning pretty normally. Now, I'll go ahead and zoom in on the screen here so you can see the temperatures. They're not great, but they're not bad either. Okay, so as we can see, the temperatures of the diodes versus the internal. I mean, the internal and temperature is what you really want to look at. Well, it's 40 Celsius and it's 104 degrees Fahrenheit, which isn't too bad. So thank you for watching. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please ask them below.
So yeah, the toothpaste and vegetable oil or olive oil does work. Unfortunately, the jimmy-rigging a heat sink does not seem to work. I'm sure you could build something that works a little better than what I tried today, but the tutorials and everything I was reading literally said you could put a tin can on and a fan on it and it'll work. And that does not seem to be the case. Maybe if you had a desk fan blowing onto the board, that'll work, but just a standard system fan does not seem to work very well. And have a great one.